these days can almost be too slick for its own good. Gone are the days of the freewheeling, fast-talking, jive-talking DJs. Well, almost.
This is the Platter Parade. 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 Let's go!
If you haven't heard of Stan the Man, then you're either under 30 or you're asleep right through the 60s.
Off the ground, it's the Stan Rofe Show.
Well, howdy, hi, Victoria, and hello, it's your old rocky jockey, Stan the Man, here once again, winning, spinning, and chinning along with all the great records of our time. And Mr. Presley, if you're listening, do me a little favor. Heartbreak me. Please heartbreak me.
Well, since my baby left me, well, I found a new place to dwell. Well, it's down at the end of Lone Street, that Heartbreak Hotel. So lonely, baby. Well, I'm so lonely. I'll be just so lonely, I could die. Although it's always crowded, you still can find.
Everybody in the entertainment business has to start somewhere, and usually you can attribute that first break to one person. The guy who gave me my first chance was none other than Stan Rofe. How are you, Stan?
Hi, Greg. You mind if I take these off?
Yeah, take those off. Do you remember...
A little uncomfortable, really.
Do you remember that night, Stan? I think it was Stonehenge, that dance that they had in Reserve Road by Morris back in 1969 when we first met.
You've got a better memory than I gave you credit for. That is a long time ago. Yes, 1969, Greg, and you were a pimply-faced little boy around about 17 years of age, if my memory serves me correctly.
So what's new? Well, he's a bit shorter now.
Well, you still look as young, except the pimples have gone.
Stan, of course, your radio career as a star disc jockey went on long before that. What, back, I think you first started in what, 1953?
53, Greg, I started many, many years ago, but let's not talk about the very early years. I think...
Memory's best forgotten.
The halcyon year, I suppose, was 1956 when I first became a disc jockey.
Right.
And, you know, the first record I ever played on the air was Heartbreak Hotel, the very first record.
One you just played.
One I just played, yes.
And that would have been 3KZ, wouldn't it?
3KZ, yes.
Times for a disc jockey then was so totally different to now.
Well, no one knew what a disc jockey was. When they said to me, you're going to be a disc jockey, I had no idea of what disc jockeys did. And then someone said, why don't you fly to Sydney? There are a couple of men up there who call themselves disc jockeys. And I said, what are their names? And they said, Bob Rogers and John Laws. So I got in a plane and with the station's help and flew to Sydney and sat down for a fortnight listening to Bob Rogers and John Laws. Mm. Then I came back and for the first 2 or 3 weeks sounded like Bob Rogers. And the next 3 or 4 weeks sounded like John Laws, you know, before Stan Rofe ever really emerged from the cocoon.
Well, Stan, a lot of people would have wanted to emulate you then because at that time you were the king of Melbourne radio and in fact the one person responsible for breaking rock and roll, weren't you?
Well, I suppose, Greg, to a certain degree, I mean, I broke rock and roll because I was the only goddamn person on the air playing rock and roll.
Hi, Stan, Brenda Lee here. You wouldn't like to see me emotionally upset, would you? Well, then, play my new record.
Dum-dum, a diddly-dum, uh-huh. A dum-dum, a diddly-dum, oh, yeah. Dum-dum, a diddly-dum.
Well, Stan, in all those years, you must have met some pretty incredible personalities, but who are the ones that come to your mind most of all?
In 28 years, Greg, I met so many people. It's just very hard to recall all the people I've met over a long, long period of time. You know, so many people stand out, you know, in my mind after so many years, but I suppose my dearest and most loved friend of all had to be Johnny O'Keefe.
I'm counting on you.
I love Johnny. I revere Johnny. And there was no one sadder than I when Johnny passed away. Johnny was a real good friend because, you see, it was Johnny that helped establish Stan the Man in all those years. You know, it was when Johnny came down to Melbourne. In fact, I think I may have helped Johnny O'Keefe in Melbourne too. Because Johnny came down to me and said, you know, some of those disc jockeys in Sydney won't play my records. And I said, well, let's make them, kid.
It's plain to see why you're the lover that I waited for.
One of the other things about your radio show, you always had little voiceover drop-ins, things that said, hi, this is Fred Nurk saying...
Oh, people like... I even got Presley to do one for me, and I had Buddy Holly doing them, and Johnny Burnett, and there was just so many of them.
Hi there, this is Don.
And this is Phil, and together we add up to 2 Everly Brothers. And here we're saying that Stan's spinners are real winners.
Pat Boone here.
Hey, what are you doing there, Stan?
Greetings, Stan. Chubby Checker here. Why don't you check in with one of my latest records?
I might just relate one very small story about John Lennon and Paul McCartney. I had to give them their gold records when they first came to Australia. And the record company manager said to me, look, there are a couple of reporters over there, female reporters, annoying John Lennon. Would you go over and bust it up and talk to John about music? They want to know about his personal life, and he doesn't want to talk about his personal life. I said, yes, I'll do that. So I got Lennon on side, then McCartney came over. And we sat there, and I said, well, humbly, you know, not knowing, because of the Beatles had written two or three pretty good songs at that stage. But I wasn't a know, neither was anyone else. They had so much more good material to come. So I said, because I had such a pile and heap of blues records and rock and roll records at home, I said, look, if you fellas ever run short of material, don't forget, either give me a ring in Melbourne, Australia, or write to me and I'll send over a lot of great stuff you can record. So don't forget, if you run short of material, you see Stan the Man.
Well, Stan, I'm sure a lot of people are very interested in the fact that you're coming back on the air this Saturday night on 3DB. Perhaps in true disc jockey fashion, you might like to tell us what we can expect to hear.
Yeah, sure, Greg, no trouble at all. Just leave it to dear old Stan the Man. I reckon I can do anything, son. Here we go.
Great balls of fire.
Great balls of fire. Mr. Jerry Lee Lewis that time, and a little record, a little sample of what you're getting here on Platter Parade. Next Saturday night between 6 and 12 midnight on 3DB. So you join Stan the Man, Melbourne's old rocky jockey, between 6 and midnight next Saturday. Meantime, let's go along with Ronnie Sulf and Bobbalina.
Whoa! Bobbalina, Bobbalina, she my gal. Oh, Bobbalina, Bobbalina, yeah, she my gal.
Hi, Stan. On behalf of Greg, myself, and the Together Tonight team, I'd like to welcome you back to Melbourne Radio and wish you all the best. How about playing a Rocky Jockey song for us?